Hello everyone, welcome on my channel again. Today I'm going to show you how to crochet this beautiful decoration for an Easter egg. My egg from the top to bottom is measured, I think, about 8.5 inches. I will double check. Yeah, and about 8.5 inches. Basically for this pattern, for this egg, we need to work two of the same small doilies. Then we have to join them together by using yarn needle, and I attach some decorations by using hot glue. For my project, I'm using a crochet thread. This is the thread, I think, quite similar to this size number of 10. The way is for crochet hook 1.75 till 2 millimeters, and I've got 50 gram ball. This is 280 meters, so maybe you will able to check the size of the thread as well. So I am using few different colors, so we need just a little bit of each color, and then I am using crochet hook size 1.75 millimeters. So let's get started. Our work, we are going to start by making slip knot, then chain of 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Now slip stitch in the first chain stitch to form ring. Then first round, chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Now into the ring we have to make another 23 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25.
I forgot. So now we've got 24, including our chain 3 from the beginning, and slip stitch in our first double crochet. So in our link we should have 24 double crochets. Second round, we are going to start by making chain 1, then single crochet into the same stitch as we've done slip stitch. Chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 into the fourth chain from the hook. 1, 2, 3 and 4. We have to make first double crochet. Then chain of 3 and slip stitch into the same stitch. Chain of 3. 1, 2, 3. Double crochet into the same stitch as the previous double crochet and previous chain 3, and then chain of 3, slip stitch into the same chain stitch. Then we have to repeat this one more time. Chain of 3, double crochet into the same stitch, then chain 3 and slip stitch into the same stitch. So we've got some kind of three leaves in one stitch, chain of two, and single crochet into the next four stitches. One, two, three, and four. So now, as you can see, we've got three leaves. One, two, and then we have to work single crochet in next four and start again. Chain of six, three, four, five, six. In fourth chain from the hook, one, two, three, and four, double crochet. Chain of three, slip stitch into the first chain stitch, then again, chain of three, double crochet into the same chain stitch, chain three, slip stitch into the same. And now one more petal, one, two, three, double crochet still in the same chain stitch, chain of three, slip stitch still in the same chain stitch. So, and now, before I will show you how it looks like, we have to make chain of two, single crochet in next double crochet, and then in next three, and after one, two, and three. So now again we are in a fourth double crochet, and this time it looks exactly the same as before. And now we have to continue. Now we have to repeat the same, then one single crochet in next four, and again and again and again, and you should have six the same repeats, six the same petals. Okay, so at the end I am changing the color from next round, so I just made slip stitch into our first single crochet, and then I cut my yarn. Now we have to start from the center petal, and basically from the double crochet. We have to join in this double crochet by using the second color, then we need to work one single crochet. So chain one, and then single crochet in the same stitch. Chain of nine, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. Then we are going directly to the next center petal, and again one single crochet in next double crochet, like this. Chain of nine, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. Then again, we are going directly to the next center petal, and we have to work single crochet into the double crochet. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. Then we have to go to the next center petal. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Into the next. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Into the next. So all the way around, now we should have six chain nine spaces. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. And this is actually the last one, and we have to work slip stitch in our first single crochet. Like this. For front, we have to start by making chain of three as a first double crochet. Then in chain nine space, we need to make nine double crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8 and 9. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then slip stitch into the last double crochet. So this is not really the picot, we need to use this loop in next round. And now into the same chain space, another 9 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. 1 double crochet into the single crochet from previous round, and we have to start exactly the same. So 9 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, slip stitch into the last double crochet and another 9 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then double crochet into the next single crochet. So now the same pattern, we need to continue all the way around. In each chain 9 space, we have to make basically 18 double crochets plus picot after the 9th double crochet. Now we've got round 5, so after slip stitch into the top of chain 3, our first double crochet, we have to make chain 1, and into the same stitch we have to make 1 single crochet. Now chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and we have to skip all 9 double crochets, and we are going directly to our loop. Now we need to work 3 treble crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, then into the same loop another 3 treble crochets. So we've got some kind of shell by making 3 treble crochets, chain 7, and another 3 treble crochets. Now chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, then we have to skip another 9 double crochets, and into the double crochet, as we've done in single crochet into the from the previous round, we have to make 1 single crochet. From now, we are going to continue our pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 3 treble crochets into the loop, on into the center of the picot. 1, 2, and 3, chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, then another 3 treble crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Chain of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then again, we have to skip all 9 double crochets and 1 single crochet into the double into the 10th. So exactly in the double crochet as we've done in single crochet from previous round. And the same pattern now, we have to continue all the way around. So at the end of my round, I've done slip stitch into the first single crochet, and now I'm going to change the color again, so I will cut the yarn. And later on we can hide the tail. The last two rounds I will be working with the blue color, and now we have to start by joining into the chain space before our shell, and a chain space but before. Chain one, then we need to work single crochet into the chain space, then half double crochet and 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we have to skip all treble crochets and we are going directly to the chain 7 space. Here we need to make 16 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Then again, we have to skip next 3 treble crochets. Into the next chain 5 space, we have to make 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, then half double crochet and single crochet. Then we are going directly to the next chain 5 space and we have to start in exactly the same way as we've done at the beginning. So single crochet, half double crochet, then 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And we have to skip our 3 treble crochets in chain 7 space, 16 double crochets again. So now basically we have to go back and start everything in exactly the same way, all the way around. And then I will go back to you in the last one round to show you how we need to finish this part. And as I said before, now we've got the last one round and we have to start by making chain 1, then single crochet into the same stitch. So at the end I've done slip stitch in my first single crochet. Now we have to work 1 single crochet into the next 10 stitches. So now is the second. So basically into the single crochet from previous round, into the half double crochet, then into the next 8 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now
we have to make single crochet into the space between last double crochet in previous chain space and first one in next one, and we have to work into the one single crochet into the space between first one and last one and first one. Now chain of four and then slip stitch into the same single crochet. So this is picot. We are working now picot. And now you have to make one single crochet into the first eight double crochets. So make sure that you are working in each double crochet. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven and eight. Now chain of five. One, two, three, four and five. Slip stitch into the first, into the single crochet. Chain of five. One, two, three, four, five. Slip stitch into the same single crochet and one more time chain of five. Three, four, five. Slip stitch into the same single crochet. So in one single crochet we've got three picots. And now one single crochet into the next eight stitches. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. And again, single crochet in a space between last one and first double crochet, chain of four, then slip stitch into the same single crochet as we've done before our chain stitches. Now we have to work one single crochet into the next 20 stitches until the space between group of 16 double crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. Then into the next group of 10 stitches. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. And we have to repeat exactly the same what we've done here. So one single crochet in a space, chain of four, slip stitch into the single crochet, then one single crochet in next eight stitches. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Chain of five, slip stitch into the single crochet. Chain of five, slip stitch into the same single crochet and one more time chain of five, slip stitch into the same single crochet. Then now one single crochet into the next eight stitches, then
single crochet into the space, picot, and again one single crochet into the next 20 stitches till next space before group of 16 double crochets. So this pattern, now we have to repeat again all the way around. So we've got picots only before, in the middle, and after group of 16 double crochets. At the end we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So our first part is done, and the second one we have to work in exactly the same way. Okay, so this is how my work looks like already. As I said, we have to make two the same parts. The second one I've done with the pink color, and basically I used pins to show you how the project supposed to look like. And we have to now join two parts together by using yarn needle. So as I said, on our egg it will be a little bit easier, but if you would like to use a balloon as a filling, you can also join these parts without egg at all. So what we have to do now? I will show you the first part, and the rest you will be able to join by yourself. So on the top ones I am using blue color because the blue one will be at the top. On the bottom I will use the pink one because when we've got two picots they are on the top and the work looks much nicer. So I'm going to start. I've done little knot at the end, but when we've got picots sometimes the knot is not big enough, so I'm trying to first make sure that my yarn will stay in one place, and then from the bottom we have to join to the bottom part like this, and we are going to the next picot and we have to join from the bottom as well. Now we have to squeeze our work, and one more time. One or two is completely up to you. It can be very hard. So now from the top to the red first, or pink, and from the pink to the blue again. And I lost my yarn now. Okay, and again. So I'm going back to the first one, and after this I will make a knot again now. So all the ends we can hide a little bit later, even by using a crochet hook. And now we can even pull the thread through more stitches by using yarn needle, and then cut a little bit later. So we can make sure that we are not losing any thread. And now I can take my pin out and our work will be look like that. So if you are not quite happy with the joining, you can always put some decorations on the top, which I am planning to do, and basically after joining each part our egg will be done. So thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial. I hope you enjoy. If you like this type of project, just put your thumbs up, leave a comment, and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.